National Education Policy 2020 is likely to influence teaching and learning in classroom. In this video, let's see what the teachers of Hima Academy Public School feel about the same.
Finally, India has got its new education policy and it calls for a complete overhaul of the current system of education in our country. जी हाँ, भारतीय शिक्षा पद्धति बदलाव की कगार पर है। सन 1948 में सर्वपल्ली डॉक्टर राधा कृष्णन जी की अध्यक्षता में राधा कृष्णन एजुकेशन कमीशन अपॉइंट हुआ था और उसकी एक विशेष रिकमेंडेशन थी, इफ वी आर टू सजेस्ट वन रिफॉर्म इन एजुकेशन देन दैट वुड बी एग्जामिनेशन रिफॉर्म। उसके बाद कई एजुकेशन पॉलिसीज आई पर शिक्षा में सुचारू बदलाव ना कर सकें। वर्षों बाद पहली बार NEP 2020 शिक्षा के स्वरूप को पूरी तरह बदलने वाली है, बिकॉज इट इज द फर्स्ट एवर पॉलिसी दैट इज गोइंग टू इंप्लीमेंट एग्जामिनेशन रिफॉर्म। इसका पहला उदाहरण CBSE के लेटेस्ट सैंपल पेपर्स में देखने को मिलता है। द पैटर्न ऑफ क्वेश्चंस इज चेंजिंग, एम्फेसिस ऑन रोट मेमोराइजेशन इज डिक्रीजिंग एंड शिफ्टिंग टू टेस्टिंग ऑफ हायर ऑर्डर थिंकिंग स्किल्स। जनरली इंग्लिश इज कंसीडर्ड एज वन ऑफ द ईजीएस्ट सब्जेक्ट्स। Let us see how the pattern of questions is changing in the CBSE board examination for subject English.
National Education Policy 2020 has brought many foundational changes to our existing education system. To keep up with the dynamics of the education system, it's important that we keep our pedagogy updated. Hello everyone, this is Shilpa. Here is a comparative study of the new pedagogy and the old pedagogy in accordance to the NEP 2020. So as we can see the first slide, which is of chapter 1 from NCERT of class 10th, A Letter to God. It's written by G.I. Fuentes. This is an extract from this chapter. Now on the basis of this extract, we have some questions. Now these questions are from the year of 2020 and the PDF that you see is from that of the year 2021. Now, the one major difference that we notice between the two questions is that these questions are one word or one sentence type, whereas these questions are multiple choice or MCQs. Then the second difference that we see is that the questions in 2020 were more direct, they were more factual, whereas the questions from 2021 are indirect. So that means they require your grammatical skills, your comprehension skills, and your evaluation skills, not just your remembering skills. Then, if we move on to the short answer type and the long answer type questions, we see that the trend is continued even here. So, in 2020, the questions were shorter, and we can see that to answer these questions, we require convergent thinking. Now, what's convergent thinking? Convergent thinking is that you have a problem, and for that problem, you have one solution. So, one solution to every problem, that's what convergent thinking is. But now, if we see the updated pedagogy, we'll see that the questions that we are getting now, they require divergent thinking. Now, what's divergent thinking? Divergent thinking is that you have a particular problem, and for that particular problem, you have multiple solutions. So, you have one problem and many solutions. So that means now students are not going to have a single solution for every question. They will have to find out their own individual answer to every question. Then moving on to the next slide. Now, what are the inferences that we can take out? That what are the differences between the pedagogy of the year 2020 and that of 2021? Now, before chapter was used as a source and now chapter is used as a resource. Before, direct questions were asked and now indirect questions are being asked. In the year of 2020, the questions were a bit shorter in length. In the year of 2021, we can expect longer or lengthier questions. In 2020, the answers were according to the chapter, but now we are expecting answers according to the individual child. So that means every child can give a different answer based on their comprehension. And finally, in 2020, the focus was on remembering, and in 2021, the focus is not just on remembering, but it is on creativity, synthesis, and evaluation. Then 2020, as we just discussed, required convergent thinking, whereas 2021 requires you to think divergently. Now, let's have a comparative study of the pedagogy which was used before and the new updated pedagogy. The pedagogy which was used before, at first what the child used to do was he used to read loudly. So loud reading was done by the students, and then the extract which was read by the child was explained by the student. So explanation was given by the student. So basically the child has just read. So that means he has used his speaking skills only, whereas the teacher has comprehended the extract and spoon-fed that extract to the child. And finally, the child has answered factual question based on the comprehension, which was not given by him, but it was given by the teacher. And finally, it was crammed or it was learned by the student. Now what we are going to do is, according to the new pedagogy, silent reading will be done by the student. And then the student will explain to the whole class that what has the child understood. So here we are making use of speaking skills as well as his comprehensive skills. Finally, after giving the comprehension, if the comprehension has some problems, then the teacher will guide them to the correct comprehension by using the QRQ technique. QRQ technique is question, response, question. So that means you ask a question, you get a response. If the response is not correct, then you do not correct the response, but you ask more questions to take the child towards the right response. So that's the QRQ technique. And finally, every extract is going to be discussed grammatically, literally, and critically. And finally, the student will be able to answer his question based on his own comprehension, not on the basis of the comprehension which is given by the teacher, but on the basis of the comprehension which is done by himself. So let me give you a brief demonstration on how we can implement this new pedagogy in the class. The extract which we just read before, this is the literal comprehension of the extract. So we have questions which are literal or factual in nature. For example, we have this question, what was written in Lencho's letter? So this is a very factual question. If you've read the chapter, you'll be able to answer this question. It's related to facts. Same way, we have this question number 3 also, to whom is the letter addressed? So this is also a factual question. If you've read the chapter, you'll be able to answer this question. Then we have grammatical comprehension. In grammatical comprehension, we are not interested in the story, or we are not talking about the story in a literal sense, but we are using the extract or the story as a resource to study grammatical skills. So we have the first question, what is the difference between affixed and fixed? Now, affixed is a noun, whereas fixed is a verb. So that's the difference between affixed and fixed. So using the same extract, you have discussed the difference between noun and verb. So that is how we can use the extract for grammatical comprehension. And finally, we have critical comprehension. Now, critical comprehension is different from literal comprehension, because in literal comprehensions, you answer factual questions. But in critical comprehension, you answer questions by using those facts as a background. So using the facts as a background, you are using that knowledge to answer questions based on your own understanding. One example of critical comprehension is, for example, if we take question number 1. The moment from went to open it. Now, what can you say about the postmaster from the above line? Now, if you've read this line, you can understand that line. But understanding that line will not be enough. You have to work on that line, and you have to think that after reading this line, what did I understand about the postmaster? What is this characteristic? And that is what you have to answer in this question. We have one more question like this. For example, if we take question number 3, Lencho asked God for money in his hard times. Would you do the same? Why or why not? Now, this question is purely based on your comprehension. Would you do the same? If yes, then why? If no, then why? So this, again, you will not get the answer in the chapter, because this is not a factual question. It's a critical thinking question. So you have to think, you have to analyze, and then only will you be able to answer. So these are the 3 comprehensions that we have: literal comprehension, grammatical comprehension, and critical comprehension. Following this approach will ultimately lead to the holistic and linguistic development of the child, where the focus will not be on the content, but on acquisition and development of various skills through the content.
Assessment guides teaching, because whatever is assessed is taught. तो जाहिर सी बात है कि इस बदलाव का प्रभाव टीचिंग पैडागॉजी पर भी होगा. द टीचर्स विल हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट गुड एक्सप्लेनिंग डजंट मीन गुड टीचिंग. दे विल हैव टू स्टॉप स्पून फीडिंग चिल्ड्रन, एंड लेक्चर मेथड विल हैव टू बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय द इंक्वायरी मेथड. Children will not sit like a passive listener. Instead, they will need to be trained to think, analyze, evaluate, and create.
To achieve all this, one of the essential skills to be developed among students is reading. And Him Academy Public School has started working on this agenda. Developing reading competency shall be taken up as a mission in the school right from kindergarten years. Let us hope that we shall implement this new education policy in its true spirit, so as to make learning joyful and stress-free for our students.